The campaign for a women's suffrage amendment to the Colorado Constitution looked more promising in 1893 than in two earlier attempts. National organizers had given up on Colorado as a grassroots movement of local women gained momentum. The Colorado Equal Suffrage Association rallied activist leaders who insisted that women would bring a redeeming touch to the evil, wicked world of politics. Local members of the nation's new populist party backed the women, society leaders got involved, and Baby Doe Tabor donated office space for the campaign in her husband's opera house. By Election Day in November, more than 10,000 Colorado women worked for the suffrage amendment, which passed with a 55% majority. Within 3 years, Martha Conein became the first woman elected to the state legislature. It took another 39 years for the appearance of Denver's first city councilwoman, Alyssa Palladino, appointed to fill a vacancy in 1935. Deborah Ortega and Ramona Martinez led the way for Hispanic women on council in 1987, followed by the 1990 election of the first African-American councilwoman, Allegra Happy Haynes. At the start of the 21st century, women were a majority of Denver City Council and participated at all levels of American politics, a testament to Colorado, the first state to affirm their equality.